Hey everyone, welcome to Kip TV, and I like the cut of this engineer's jib. Whatever a jib is. Anyway, I think that's a saying. We will get started. We are in Badwater, you can tell, because I'm watching the NG rollout. Paulito Top Pantail is engineer for Random Assortment of Gents, a steel Highlander team, steel blue, I believe. Anyway, we have red is Random Assortment of Gents. We have rags on sniper. Coliseum, oh, that's cute, is Scout This Bloom, is Soldier Eli, is Dumb Man Axel, Pan Pizza is Pyro, Dr. Druattini is Spy Boaz, I'm going to say, or we're just going to say Boa 52 is Medic, and Steve is Heavy. Let's go ahead and meet the blue team. It is the High Council. We have Cyanide. Oh, that's cute too. These teams, cute names. I love it. Is Medic Gary, is Soldier Cornholio, is Demo, Tracef is Sniper, Danny O is Engineer, Hose, Call Me Derby, Darby is, you know, the heavy guy, Coatnip is the pyro guy, Duff is spy guy, and Sputnik is scout. There we go. Looks like we have a regular setup right here for NG at first point, so let's see what happens. I'm excited about this game. I was told it was very, very close. And both these teams coming in 1-1, so one win, one loss. So they both want to make a winning record right here, and I do not blame them much for that. So far, we're seeing pretty standard. Rags did go down a sniper, but that's not going to break this first defensive hold. We do have. Oh, I thought I saw the medic. Yes, Cyanide is flirting with coming out right here, but has not so far made the commitment. Yeah, that's what you get with flirting. Rarely making a commitment. Meanwhile, Sputnik and his engineer are pushing the cart all the way. Does the sentry gun look over? It is being wrangled at the moment, so it is not going to be able to look down at the cart. Finally, it does have an eye on the cart. And so, yeah, that's a dangerous position for the scout right there. But regardless, we do have the Uber is popped right there. Sentry gun goes down. Red Uber. Oh. Does not last as long, and Boa taking a lot of damage. We'll have to fall back, and this is pretty much the end of this first hold on defense. Oh, really nice push right there from Blue. They had those numbers. They had the coordinated push. Let's watch Duff see as he's actually coming in from behind on the roof. Caught out by the medic, but Rags? I'm sorry, Boa goes down right there. Rags is the tag, of course, with some help from Blue Soldier. So Blue just right now rolling. THC putting a good time right here on second. It'll be under 2 minutes, which is a very, very nice time. And now doing a little camping of this secondary spawn door, which is totes legit. Totes legit. That is a professional term we use in the casting industry. we're going to just keep on the Duff's cam right here because he is staying alive and we'll get behind the lines a little bit. Actually, taking a lot of damage. We'll see what happens. Cyanide right now. Actually, we'll go to that cam because that's a little bit more interesting. Because THG is just rolling right now. Nothing can stop them. Rags is just not having enough time to build up a defense. And here comes the Uber pop, and this is not going to be good for THC. Oh, we do have a Pyroblast, and that actually significantly delays this Uber push. However, Heavy will get in there, and Hose, Call Me Darby, is doing a good job pushing back the red team. Not getting a lot of kills, but again, pushing that team back. But, however, here comes Red Heavy Steve, and he's got an Uber of his own, and Hose call him Steve. He's only got one health left. Oh my goodness, he thought his medic was on him, but he's not. He will fall back, but not gonna survive that. Oh man, so really fortunate right there. Oh, but look at the spy go crazy. Dr. Dratini getting 2-3 Ks right there on the cart. That's gonna help his team significantly. We do have that Uber ready for Red, but right now at this point, they gotta hold on to that. Missed that pop on Steve earlier, which would have made the Ubers even. But those backstabs on the cart really saved them. So not all is lost for Rags' defensive hold right here, although 2 minutes and 10 seconds is a ridiculously fast time. So they definitely have to put up some sort of ridiculously amazing defense. Here comes the Uber pop, and we do have a return pop on Red. Popped interestingly on the demo as he's just trying to get a bunch of spam back there, and nice pills take down Cornholio and Cyanide. So nice job right there, waiting for that Uber to be off, and then some nicely placed pills and take them down. Rags' medic did survive right there, so Boa in a good position to have an Uber advantage. So that's the start of a good defense. That is what they need. Let's check in on some of these. Oh, look how far Eli is is pushing up. I like this, but at the same time, it's very scary, especially when there's a pyre there who can air blast us, stick his right back into your medic's face. So maybe fall back at some point. It looks like that's exactly what he's going to do, at least to reload. Let's check on this blue who is doing the ranger soldier, which I'm trying to start ranger as the new term for roaming soldier, because ranger is so much more cooler than roaming. But it does take down Cornholio, so that's... Oh man, that's a nice name. And we meanwhile just caught a glimpse of that nice headshot. Dr. Dratini taking down a hose, call me Darby. Let's see if this blue can finish off the pyro in the map, or secondary map room. I think this is called secondary map room, right? I mean, that's what I'm just calling it now, but it's not map room, it's not... Not map room. Oh, look at this Colosseum. Cannot forget that amazing name. Just scouting out on the roof right there. Check in on the rags cam. Nope, he's gonna take a lot of damage, so we will check in on him later. Meanwhile, we do have the Ubers popped. Blue's gonna run out very fast, and red, no switching there at the Uber, so they're gonna hold on for a little bit longer. We do have the scout in on the medic, but Boaz will survive, and Gary goes down as well as Sputnik. Sorry, the soldier was in on there. That was Gary. So trying to get a medic pick right there, not going to happen. Meanwhile, Cyanide did stay alive, so we will have about uber even advantages. What I was going to say there? Equal uber advantage. Even whatever. You know what I'm saying. As Duff, we saw he got to kill right there anyway. So time is ticking. We've seen two failed pushes already from THC. They can't afford many more. Well, they can't afford many more. They have 6 minutes and 45 seconds. They can afford about 6 more failed pushes. Or 5 more failed pushes, and that last one has to be successful. But we will see. Right now, Spy is doing crazy amount of work. I was just checking on the scores. Actually, Duff not up there, but I thought he would be. But Dratini getting 10 points. And of course, some of those double points for backstabs. And then he did get a nice headshot. So we'll check in. Rags does have this Uber ready. We'll see if they decide to be defensive or offensive with it. They've been pretty playing it safe right now, and they have to. But Duff is in here. Oh, he could get a pick on the medic with that Uber. No, caught out by the heavy. Does Dead Ring out of that situation. We have the blue Uber popped. Red needs to pop in order to save somebody right there. Finally, do get the pop off. Oh, but the sentry gun is so going down. Yes, it does go down, but the red Uber is going to take out the medic, and most of the blue team, only 3 up right now for THC. And actually going to try to catch out the scout and the spy right here. The vampires are running away, but okay defense right there. Red really has to rebuild fast, whereas blue has to push and take advantage that the all the engineer stuff is down. And we'll watch Cornholio as he's just spamming right now, trying to get out some damage, trying to push back the team. Rags' medic Boa did go down right there. So that's again going to buy a nice advantage to, for the first time, a nice advantage by Cyanide. We just saw a nice pill to the face to take out Dr. Dratini. Cornholio, though, is super hurt. Gonna fall back. Gonna have to fall back right there. Yeah. Yeah, let's check in on the sniper cams. Oh, I'm sorry, Rick. I'm sorry, Riku. I tend to do that. Bring terrible luck to snipers, spies, everyone. We're gonna have a little scout battle on, see which scout I bring good luck to or bad luck to. Sputnik, oh, does take out Colosseum right there. Sputnik, of course, the first scout in space. He has that distinction. Does go down to Dr. Dratini. However, Duff is in the map room right now. Could do a lot of damage. We actually saw Cyanide go down while I was putzing around on the... Sniper and scout and spy cam. We saw Uber either being popped or dropped. Whoops. Let's check out the Colosseum cam. He just took out a heavy or a soldier that was behind the point right now. So he's been doing some nice work just patrolling that side right here, this yard. They can very easily, oh, hey, you found a sniper. Oh, it takes out Tracef right there, so nice. Again, doing nice work. He's not necessarily pushing or trying to be too aggressive, but just patrolling these areas that is pretty much shutting down Blue's access to these flanks. One scout, though, is kind of vulnerable, even if your name is awesome as Colosseum. Of course, Colosseum was the first koala to battle in the Colosseum in ancient Rome, and he's just gonna go back to his perch right there, which is totes legit as well. We do have the blue uber popped, red uber popped in retaliation, of course, this time on the pyro, which I definitely agree with, going to blast that uber back away from the sentry gun, little chasing after the heavy action. Too bad he doesn't have the back burner, but oh hey, there's a sentry gun right there. Pyro did get cyanide and the heavy though, so nice work right there from that defensive pyro. Love to see that. Axel, of course, is his name right there. Don't go any further, Sputnik. There's a level 3. Oh, right. Sputnik is blue. He's right. The level 3 is actually down right there. Good calls on that one. Brought to you by Kip. Sorry about that, guys. There's just always so much going on, and you want to capture it all. Duff kind of gives away his position right there by taking all that stuff, but he definitely needed it. He actually goes undetected, gets the stab on the sniper, tries to get a few more before the sentry gun gets him, but not able to do so. Let's trust the Cotnip. I'm assuming that's Cotnip. Oh, do we have a pause? We have a pause. And apparently someone's ping spiked a little bit. Meanwhile, Raikou pointed out in chat his ping has been at 900 this whole time. Looks like it is just falling down, so maybe we'll see some solid sniper snips out of... I can't think of another S word, but you know what I'm saying. Looks like the flanks have been compromised right here as Scout and Spy for Blue are patrolling it. Spy did drop down trying to get some saps, not able to do so. Here comes Blue though, and the hut is not refreshed, so they did have an Uber as they pushing in. Red does not have anything. Oh, actually, HUD now just refreshing. And so Red will have this Uber ready in time if they so need it. Looks like they will probably not have to pop it. They may be well advised to keep Ubers even and just keep this medic alive because there's a ton of spam coming out. But it looks like they are going to play it safe, and Aboa is just going to hold on to that while he can. I'm just assuming everybody on Random Assortment of Gents is a man, but even though there can be gentle women, a term generally that has not been used since the 1870s, but is still an appropriate term in English. I think it's in the dictionary. So maybe there is a gentle woman on Rags. I don't know. I'm just assuming there's everyone who is a gentleman, so we'll see. Anyway, Gary is taking out Coliseum, so again, Coliseum having a little bit more trouble patrolling this flank area right here. Probably use some backup, but the way that his team has been holding is actually really, really impressive. Look at that, we have 1 minute left. THG has not been able to cap this last point, even though they had 6 minutes and 45 seconds at one point. 2 minute 10 seconds time on 3 points, absolutely ridiculous, but this last point of Badwater can be so annoying. That gives nothing up for this spectacular defense. Sentry gun for the most part has stayed up, and when it did go down, it was very rapidly built back up. And look at that protection. Look at that protection. I love it. Pyro just constant air blasting. That's why the spy for Blue has not been able to do anything. Duff has just been stymied in his efforts. Oh, look at this. We have the level 2, level 3 sentry gun brought up to the cliff area, or the terrace area. We'll see if it can do any damage. We do have the red uber popped, but after it wears off, medic's gonna be very vulnerable, but sentry gun goes down. Steve taking it out finally. However, we have Duff taking out Steve on the point. Only 4 up for red. Will he get those respawns in time to stop the cart? We are in overtime, so will we have anyone? We have the medic with the uber saw out, but no cyanide, not able to do anything. Not over yet. We do have Scout on the point, but it's 3v1. He did touch the cart, however, so can anybody from Blue get in here? We have some stickies, but stickies can't cap the cart, and there we go. Red does defend with a stellar, almost 7-minute defense right there. I think it actually was 7 minutes. Anyway, fantastic work by Random Assortment of Gentlemen, or Gentle Ladies, which I guess is also another word for it. That doesn't sound as right, though. Anyway, let's see what THC can put up. Again, they have to stop... Oh, it's so confusing. I hate payload rules. If somebody does a cap, it's really confusing. So, I don't see any suicides right here. Oh, there we go. Okay. Gary suicides gallantly for his engineer. But that's just one. Usually I like 3 on my first point in Badwater. We'll see. All right, there's the second one. Sputnik going down. But we'll see if Danny O can put this... Oh, yeah, we're gonna have a soldier dude number 3. There we go. All right, so he did get his 3. Just in a little delayed fashion. Hopefully his team can get back up and support him. Let's just watch the death cam. But what was I saying? Oh, yes. So blue has to cap, can win this round either by capping all the points or getting to the third point in less than 2 minutes and 10 seconds, which is extremely difficult. You probably can't really beat that time, but we'll see what random assortment of gentlemen pull out. Keep on the duff cam as he's just doing some nice scouting work. He doesn't know he's a spy. Oh, but medic has been brought out of spawn immediately. They are really going for this early push right here. Duff is going for that backstab. We'll stick on his cam as he is so far unnoticed. Has a decloak. Will he get the stab? He does! Forces the uber drop right there. Oh, Duff with a nice pick right now. He is probably shouting out and mumble, "Guys, medic down! Medic down! Uber dropped! I'm awesome! Give me accolades! I am spy!" And oh, but Rags is medic going. I'm sorry. I got confused again. Okay, but Cyanide still holding on to his uber, so we will just see that defensive hold this uber. Both teams have been pretty defensive and not really aggressive with their uber advantages on defense, which makes sense. That's definitely the way to play, especially on steel when you're still getting used to some of these game mechanics. Now, having said that though, Random Assortment of Gents has been around since Season 6. I don't know how the players have changed, but just in terms of their name and their registration on UGC, which my research brought up, they are an old team. If you want to say 1 year is old, which I do want to say, because that's significant that they've been able to pull something along. A nice backstab right there from Dr. Ticini. The cart, meanwhile, is continuing to be pushed. Sentry gun went down. Is at level 2 right now. Should be able to protect for a little bit longer. It is being wrangled. Ida, he needs more protection. His Hyro is nowhere to be found, so Engineer Danio is getting spammed by all sorts of fun stuff. And finally, he's just going to just sit there and whack it, which sounds dirty. Probably is, but whatever. Medic goes down. Boa was all by himself trying to push the cart, and not gonna have it. Oh, finally, Danny O does take big casualties. Oh, talking about medics doing crazy things. We have a red medic trying to stay the cart, and the cart actually will be delayed for just a little bit longer. They are trying to hold this point, but it doesn't really matter because Blue has all the time in the world to cap all 4 points. So, not sure. It was a good try to hold it right there to just delay that time as much as possible, but not completely necessary. Oh, we have a sneaky spy up here on a roof trying to do some damage, supported by his soldier right here, and that's pretty much going to stop this buildup on roof. This blue, yep, doing some nice work, taking out that pesky scout. I think the adjective I use for scout the most is pesky. We have a nice backstab. Duff taking out this blue, but the Duff going down to some stickies from Eli. And again, we're not seeing this hold on roof. A couple of Badwater matches that I have cast, nobody's been able to hold roof, which is really interesting because that's, I mean, when I play pugs or pubs, which are definitely indicative of how you should play competitive, roof is always the easiest to hold. So of course this that means nothing, but it's just interesting to see that these second and third points have just been easy rolls for both of these teams. I'm assuming it will be. We do have a sentry gun up here, but Danny O is... he's behind here. Tricky, tricky little Danny O. Does have support of his medic, but needs his pyro with him to air blast. We do have Uber almost ready for a cyanide. I wonder if he'll pop it on the engineer. I'd love to see that. The point does get capped, but that sentry is still up. Danny taking down Steve right there. Oh, we do have a spy in here taking... Oh, out Cornholio, the uber is popped. Spy is still alive and doing some dancing on top of that sentry gun. Finally, sentry goes down. Danio's gonna pick up his dispenser and go get out of there, which is definitely the right idea. Riku, watching some sniper cam, takes a pill in the face, which you never like to see that coming through your scope. We actually do have this somewhat stable defense now. Red is pushing up a little too far. They gotta be careful not to overextend. THC still has 9 minutes to defend this last point. And that is going to be a very hard defense, but we saw Rags do something very similar. And of course, Badwater last can be crazy difficult. Duff is in an interesting position here in the house, but he's gonna probably burn to death as we see just this amorphous blob of fire running around. Yeah, amorphous. Pretty good word. Hose, call me Darby's, does not realize that not only is the entire team in front of him, but the spy is behind him and he goes down right there. Let's see if Danny O has fallen back. Yes, he has a sentry gun up level 3, so he's in pretty good shape. We do have a Uber ready for the red team, so Cyanide. Oh, Dr. Dratini. Still alive, though. That's scary. That is scary for Cyanide right now. I think they thought he was down, and there indeed is his dead body, but the Dead Ringer, one of the most infuriating weapons ever if you're not a spy. Indeed, he is still up. Here comes the Uber drop, and yeah, Dr. Dratini's gonna get in there and get that sap on there just in time for the Stickies to take it out. We do have the red Uber popped in retaliation, but blue is just everywhere. I don't think that Hose, Call Me Darby, knows that the soldier is behind him. Heavy got tunnel vision right there. Only two up right now. Four red. Oh, nice headshot. Takes down Cyanide, and that's probably going to be the end of this hold for THC. So, a nice push right there from Rags wins them the round after a very nice defense. So, there we go. Let's take just a little quick look at scores. Oh, we see Dr. Dratini is actually leading his team in points right now. Actually leading the server, so love to see some of that crazy spy action. Anyway, we'll be right back with the second round. Get okay. We are back with the second round, and this time THC has the chance to defend first, whereas Blue will push first. Danny O running the vanilla wrench. Interesting. Looks like he's having some lag issues. 160, 200 ping. Gotta stop those downloads. This is where you yell at your roommate for downloading all of the episodes of Sabrina the Teenage Witch. And, or you ask your mom to stop using the blender. My blender, of course, is connected to the internet. It's actually pretty fancy. I just worry about the day that it becomes self-aware and takes over all the other appliances. Anyway, we will see what kind of opening push Rise can put together. They did a nice push earlier, in the last few points. Of course, they did lose their medic in that opening push, so you can bet Boa is going to be yelling at his team to protect his back and also turning around like crazy. We will go ahead and watch his cam and watch his back for him and yell at him to turn around. By the way, I love the matching, well, I guess they're not matching, but I like the unusuals going on the Rags team. They are certainly gentlemen. Because gentlemen have green flames coming out of their head. Okay, so Rex is kind of making me nauseous with all of his... Oh, I'm sorry. Boa is making me nauseous with all of his dodging and whatnot. So we'll go to the free cam and see what we got going on. Pretty much standard as we see. Blue is still kind of just pushing the cards. Need to get it through the tunnel. We do have Spy in here, but Duff goes down. So knowing that Spy is down is going to be huge for confidence levels of this blue push. Indeed, they have all the components necessary. Pyro up, Demo up, Heavy up, ready to do this push. It's going to be complicated by the fact that Red Pyro is ready to push back, but right now they're just waiting possibly for a push or their spy to get into position. Indeed, there goes a spy, and actually there goes a sentry gun. The pop almost not even needed right there, but oh, huge, huge Axel taking down Cyanide before he could get that pop. What a push right there for Blue. However, spy in on everyone, takes down Heavy, but caught out before he can do too much damage. And again, still a good push from Rags. So only three up right now for Red, and that was super successful. A very well coordinated, I was questioning why Blue is waiting for so long, but they're just waiting for their soldier with a direct hit to get into position. And then, oh, I think this Blue was running direct hit, and then he must have changed. And then there's Spy to get into position too, and it's very well coordinated and very well done. Let's see, air shot, no. Air shots are so freaking hard. But this Blue is on the demo hunt and does get Gary before he could do too much damage. Only Gary is the only one dead though for Red, so Red is doing a good job falling back. They need to continue doing that. Duff is in on the car and takes down Steve again. Poor Steve and his poor back just covered in knife holes, which is probably really gross. Yeah, I don't know why I said that. Sputnik get in here trying to do anything possible to delay this cart to buy his engineer some more time to set up. Also, if they're keeping track of Uber advantages, they've got to know that Ubers are even right now and ready to be charged, so a drop or a force would be huge right now for THC. They do have this level 3 search gun, level 3 dispenser up in a position that actually I like. But, and with the Pyro there, they do have a good defense. However, Cyanide goes down. I missed that shot. Dang nabbit. And no medic for Red. It means that Center Gun goes down pretty easily. Danny O goes down as well. And this push from Rags is just going to continue rolling. Duff is in behind them, so we're going to stay on his cam. As remember, Duff was leading the server at halftime with points. Does take down the Pyro right there. Axel, an agony. Of course, his back full of knife holes too. Well, at least one. Can Duff save this? I'm gonna stick on his cam because he could do some significant work right here if he gets a chain stab, but he is caught out and so will be denied with some nice fight tracking Steve and the Demo Man as well. Here comes the last final push from Rags. Well, they're hoping it's the last final push. Dr. Dratini getting some nice work done, and actually I was mistaken. It was Dr. Dratini who is leading the server in points, not Duff, but Duff certainly doing his best right there to help his team out. We have a level 1 sentry gun. Heavy class is not here to support poor Danny O, and it goes down immediately. A scout just standing straight up and taking a headshot down. Taking a headshot to going down to a headshot, whatever. That's a scrappy defense from Red. As 2 minutes and 54 seconds. is surprisingly not the best time we've had in this game for capturing 3 points, which is absolutely ridiculous because 2:54 is a great time. We will see if Red can hold on for 8 minutes and 45 seconds. They were not able to do so in the first round. We saw that Rags just continued their role and continued their very successful push and were able to take the first round very, very handily. So we just holding on right now as Boa has about 70%. Cyanide also the same. And we'll see. Let's check on some of these assassin classes who could do like terrible, terrible damage with their good placed backstab or well placed backstab or headshot. Trey just trying to go for the P and does get some urine out there. I don't think the sentry gun can take urine. Anyway, we do have this Uber pop. Eli getting stickies down there and taking down the sentry immediately. Red is going to try its best to keep blue off the cart. They're going to have this Uber for a very long time after. Gary doing some nice work on the point, as well as Hose Call the Darby. And a push right there just stopped in its tracks by blue. Cyanide did a good job holding onto his Uber, and that enabled his team to have that Uber for at least 3 or 4 seconds after blue's Uber faded. So that's going to be very significant, and they're using this time to push up, which is a good idea. They just can't overextend, which it doesn't look like they're doing right now, so that's looks like they're in good shape as they are building as well. Cyanide is going to have an uber advantage. We'll see if they decide to use it to maybe take down Boa before he can get his full charge. I don't know. We haven't seen that yet. Both these teams playing pretty conservatively is not the right word, but smart, I believe, is probably the right word. We do have, oh, I love this. Coliseum is running the Boston Basher, and so he is building with his medic right now, and they actually will have this Uber relatively soon. Do have it now. Oh, Spy coming in, trying to do something right there, but not going to happen today. Duff being absolutely denied. Medic Boa is still with this Uber, and if I were him, I'd be very, very nervous at this point. They did lose this blue, so they will not have him for their push if they decide to go right now. However, fast respawns on offense will maybe enable them to push relatively soon. Here comes this blue indeed. We'll see if this push is coming. I'm gonna stick on the Boa cam, because why not? Looks like they're going to go through map room. They know that sentry gun is right beneath map room because that is the position of the day for, at least for Danny O. Pop comes and Boa having trouble getting out this window. The sentry gun was moved. How sneaky, sneaky of Danny O. Finally, they do get out the window. Take down the Spencer. Take down Danny O. However, Boa goes down. We'll see if Rice can continue this. Poor Cyanide also goes down right there to a backstab. And you think Did he pop his Uber? I'm not exactly sure, but only four for red right now. We'll see if Blue can capitalize on this. They are very, very hurt, though, and just some of them just now respawning. We'll see if they can get this together. We're going to have a jumping soldier battle, and unfortunately, this Blue, or unfortunately for this Blue, he craters out right there. And it looks like Rags is not going to be able to take advantage of that. Some more scout-on-scout action here on the flanks. We'll see Coliseum is definitely winning that scout-on-scout action. Sputnik, well, not necessarily. Just the few times we've been to Coliseum, he's been taking out Sputnik. So, unfortunate for Sputnik. Camera work, so I apologize about that. We'll see Riku. How is his ping doing? I can't read. Riku is down, but still up 94. I'm wondering where this server is or where these people, these gentlemen are, because they all have kind of hefty pings, considering. But doing much better this round, getting some headshots. Did he get that? He got the assist on that. Stupid this Blue getting all the glory for what should have been his charged shot. We'll see, though. So yeah, Riku's doing much better, though, this round, so I have no doubt that his ping was really at 900. Anyway, Blue Uber popped. Again, taking out the sentry gun. Danny O goes down immediately. We do have red popping, and again, they delay theirs very expertly. Boa going down, Coliseum going down right here. This Blue is going to try to get in here and do some damage, but he's pretty much alone. We do have the Pyro, but Pyro took some crazy damage and goes down as well. Dratini is in here, takes down Cyanide, which is a huge pick right there for the Spy, but will not be able to survive long enough. Riku trying to get in there to get Jurati, did take down Duff, a good pick for a sniper right there, but Blue is just desperately trying to get in here. I don't know if Rags is going to be able to, because this defense has been so stubborn from Red. Indeed, they are all up there, respawned. Homeboy, or Hose Call Me Darby. I was gonna call him Homeboy, but that's not correct at all. It's Hose Call Me Darby. Spun up and not letting anybody near his cart. So, another successful defense. Riku getting a headshot on Sputnik. Didn't see it, but we heard it because the scouts are so noisy and so loud. Now we're gonna have a little spy bot battle right here in the flanks. Oh, Dr. Dratini had enough of the revolvers and decided to go for the reliable old knife. Can't blame him there. Red has a few numbers down right now, but it's not going to be significant enough. Who's Call Me Darby? It did go down, but as long as we have that demo man who's been doing a really good job when Cyanide could hold on to his Uber and the demo man, let's see, get distracted. Gary, who's the demo man, has been getting those Uber pops after Blue has. He's been doing a really good job shutting down that Blue push. So as long as Gary is alive and Cyanide is alive, it's probably not the best idea to push. Boa will have an Uber advantage right here. I don't know if they know it. Keeping track of Uber advantages, again, is one of those things you have to get accustomed to. I say Rag should be doing it, because if they've been around since Season 6, they should know this game, this stuff. They were Steel Season 6 and then Iron in 7 and 8, I believe. So we moved back up to Steel this season. Different game, but wow, look at these reflex. Love it. Not getting anyone with it, but saving the engineer's life. And that is a Pybro. Pybro to the nth extent, or something like that. But anyway, we'll see. Steel is definitely different this season. Already seeing Sputnik. Let's get on the Sputnik cam, because we have not been getting enough of his stuff. There we go. He's pushing forward a little bit. But yeah, Steel's a different story this season. I feel like all the divisions are different stories. Everything is getting so much more competitive. Players and teams are getting more strategic and more serious, well, at least some of them. So the teams that are getting more serious are scary. And so you can have really great defense and really great offense and crazy strategies from these Steel teams. We do have a Blue Uber going off. Red again has held onto those forever. Duff getting in here. Did he get a stab? He did take down Altini. Red Uber is wearing off again. But again, it was Gary who got most of this. We'll see if he can't finish off. Well, there he goes. Steve's going down. Duff again was in good positioning. And Red is going to hold on. Very, very hurt. All of them very, very hurt. And actually, Cyanide going down to Axel. And the reserve shooter, and it's not going to be enough for Rags. They have one chance left. They will have this Uber in time, especially if they're building, and there is a... There is Coliseum, who will help build, no doubt, with that Boston Basher. Oh, Danny O goes down! I didn't see it, but you did hear it. But don't worry, Pyro's on it. And we do have the Homewrecker, but it's not going to be enough. Cannot stop those Rocket Spam from Map Room. A really good coordination, again, from the Rags team. We'll see if they can take advantage of it. Still no Engineer. They don't have an Uber. I'm not sure about this. As Medic goes down right there. Oh, man. Boa was a little too far pushed forward. However, Heavy is still alive. Steve is still doing work. Will not survive for too much longer. But don't worry, the Engineer is nope. So Politov not able to do so. Is anybody alive for either team right now? It's actually just a mini sentry gun, and unfortunately, mini sentries cannot cap points. Tracef getting a nice shot on it there, and actually, it looks like Blue will have a few players left to stop or start this cart again, but Red is just getting those respawns in time. Oh man, my host called me. Darby's doing good work, did not realize that the medic was trying to get in with his Uber Saw, but doesn't matter. Boa going down. Again, can anybody do this? And no, THC will successfully defend. Wow, so kind of seeing an exact replay of the first round, except this time THC put together a crazy awesome defense to stop Rags. So this is getting really interesting. Very, very interesting. And maybe I was psychic when I said that Duff was leading the server when it was actually Dratini, because now Duff is up there in points. Second in the server in points. So, you're welcome, Duff, for my misspokenness. I think it was misspoken. I think it was Dratini who was leading. But Dratini not far behind with 34 to Duff's 35. So, spies. Spies on Badwater. Yeah, no words. Let's get on the Sputnik cam. I said I would earlier. But first we gotta check out what this spray is. I am you. Oh, that's scary. We also have... Oh, okay, so just a repeat everywhere. It's very sloppy. The paint's running. They should have invested in a better quality spray paint. Anyway, we'll watch Sputnik as he just gets in here and actually probably just gonna push the cart. No, he's leaving that to his engineer, but goes down to a pill. And actually, yeah, Danny O's just gonna do this by himself. He's got no problem with that. Engineers are used to the unglorified work. It is what we do. It is what we do best. And we'll see, again, just seeing the standard type of play from these teams. Medic still in spawn right there. Cyanide definitely not wanting to drop, although I don't think he has dropped coming out of spawn yet. That was, unfortunately, Boa's territory. first round. Right there. See if a spy... Oh... Dratini actually does, yeah, get scary finally on the fall down. However, this Uber has popped and consistently blown back right there. Red has yet to pop the Uber. Sentry gun goes down. Why haven't they popped here is my question. But Boa is just holding strong, and finally he does. Down to 13 health and finally pops. And he's actually going to use that Uber to get out, which is not a bad idea as Blue is pushing... Well, actually, why can't I see what's happening on the cart? Boa, yeah, it's just gonna continue running back right here. So Red does still have some defensive placement, but actually, no, it was Eli, and Eli goes down again to Duff. Ouch, that side poke has got to hurt. And there we go, Blue will cap as time continues rolling down. And now, remember, in order for them to win, one of the ways for them to win is to cap the third point in less than a minute and 10 seconds right now, which they could possibly do. They have times three. Well, actually, they have times six on the cart. They only need times three, but why not? Oh, Gary going down to Dr. Dratini. And actually, I was mistaken. Duff did not take down Eli before. It was Dr. Dratini who took down the... I'm just getting these spies confused because they've been doing such great work. Now, interesting, Blue was pushing and got the cap while Red has a defense set up on roof. What? Really curious strategy right there from THC that at least they didn't know that there was this defensive setup, or they just didn't care. They're like, we can do this without taking that down. But regardless, it is still up there, and there's an Uber ready to be popped as well. And again, it doesn't really matter about this 20 seconds left for blue to cap a third. I mean, they like to do that because it'd be a shorter round, and then that takes it to a third round with some momentum. However, not completely necessary. And again, red is holding on to this uber for quite a bit of time. Finally, it is popped, but out of position, and there's nobody to kill on blue. So we will watch as they... I think at this point they need to fall back and get something sturdy up at third. Well, I don't know, they could still potentially defend roof right here. I'm very confused about these choices by Rags, and also THC. And also this building right here. That is going to be really, really difficult. Again, this spawn door is no longer open, so you can't, like, retreat back into that. Closest ammo is in the house right here, and... I don't know about this. I think at this point, red defense needs to definitely fall back. And, of course, easy for me to say. Oh, we heard a agonizing call from the medic, and then that was really kind of gross. I don't know why I put the camera on that. But, indeed, medic down for red. Cyanide, that is going to have this 100% as they push in. This blue is trying to get him to drop it, but not going to happen. Cyanide... wasn't born yesterday, and they're pushing forward, but there's nobody in red to kill. Red does have numbers, just where are these numbers? Well, Engineer is set up in the house right here in a very standard position I've seen used before, but not... There we go, it will be a level 2. We'll see if he can get some support, though. Yep, not gonna happen there. Well, maybe, okay, no! Oh, what? Sentry gun does go down, and Duff finally finishes off Politov right there. See if Coliseum can stop this cap. He is not able to do so. And man, we got 10 minutes for Rags to defend. We'll see if they can pull off another crazy defense, but it's going to be really hard. Of course, I think I've said that every single time, and sometimes they've been able to, and the first round they were able to. Second round, THC was able to. So, we'll see. That's pretty much the only thing you can see. I'm trying to get more Sputnik cam, but he's just being a scout and pushing the cart on Badwater. What else can you say about that? We do have an Uber ready for Blue. Let's see. We'll get on the Hose Call Me Dari cam, as I think they know where this sentry gun is and are ready to take it down. Gotta pop it soon, and there we go. Steve caught out. Gotta take down this level 2, but oh! Hose, I see what happened. Medic got blown back, and Hose got taken off that Uber and instantly explodes. Red is really, really hurt right now. They do have some numbers. No, numbers are falling rapidly as they are getting some respawns. Blue is respawning faster, and we'll see if they can take advantage of their push a little bit faster. But Hose is back up. He is spun up. Nobody's seen... Getting the scout though, finally fire in on here and takes out Sputnik. But oh, Axel, oh, I definitely thought he was going down to a backstab right there. But looks like Duff is just gonna try to do this the old fashioned way and just keep pushing and not kill anyone. Not a bad idea, just pull out that dead ringer and just sit on the cart all day is definitely a strategy used by some teams in payload. But looks like that defense will hold for the time being if they can get up at a level 3 though. Is the question. We have not seen a lot of Cornholio cam. Okay, well he's gonna get some heals and then we'll come back to the Cornholio cam. Because Cornholio is fun to say. Cornholio, what is he doing? Doing some ranger action, trying to secure the map room. He's jumping down right there, just trying to get some damage on that sentry gun. Oh, what are you doing? Oh, what are you doing? Cornholio, again, trying to take one for the team, but not able to do so. Look how close that cart is. It's very close to falling into what I can only assume are barrels of root beer, because that's how Team Fortress 2 plays it. However, Cyanide is close to an Uber right now, so I guess Cornholio was just kind of like, alright, we'll just try this, and then we have one Uber push ready to go, and he definitely respawned in time, so not a bad idea. I mean, soldiers constantly die on Highlander. Especially in payload, when they're just kind of doing that all-over action. And trying to protect the flanks, and trying to cause drops, or force ubers. And you see just right now he's just spamming the door, so not a bad idea. We will have this Uber coming in fast and furious. Indeed, it is popped on the Demo Man, but we do have the pop on, actually, the Heavy. Where is the Pyro? Finally, Pyro gets in on this action, does some air blasting, and breaks up that Uber. Oh yeah, Cyanide is caught out, but meanwhile, we have the Sniper and NG pushing this cart. Oh, and they do get it in. THC finally capping right there, and that is going to be a win for them, and that means we're going to go to a round three. Let's take a look at these scores. Duff and Dr. Dratini doing work as spies on payload. Gotta love it. Got to love it. All right, we'll be right back. All right, we're back with the third round. And we'll see if the tradition or trend of this match will continue. That is, the first half of the first round, the team does not cap last, and the second half of the round, the team does cap. So looking good for Rags if that trend does continue. We will see, though. Of course, nothing predestined in TF2, except that if you hold on to Kritzkrieg too long, you will drop it. That is, I think, one of the only guarantees of TF2. Another guarantee is if you are playing on a Skyle server and you have the full Heavy 2-2 set, you can wear that, which is probably my favorite thing ever. So if you ever see me on a Skyle server playing Heavy, definitely give me a high five, and I will spam all of the Fairy 2-2 sayings, which are adorable. I know it's pretty girly of me to say, but there's a lot of masculine imagery in TF2, so when you do have that's a couple girly things, you kind of latch onto them. Plus, it's freaking 2-2 in a tiara. I mean, come on. What little girl didn't prance around in that? Oh, man. Actually, I didn't. I was much too sophisticated as a child. Anyway, we are watching this round three, and whoever wins this, of course, will win this hard-fought match. And again, these teams are 1-1 in Steel Blue, so they definitely want to pick up the season and make it a winning one, or at least bring it to a winning point. And I like this view. Let's see how high we can go. That's pretty darn high. Okay, now I'm getting a little sick. but we do have both Ubers ready. We'll watch Tricep as he tries to go for this hedge on an engineer, which actually would be huge. But we do have these Ubers coming in, as Boa did pop in time enough to save the sentry gun. The sentry gun is pretty vulnerable right now as Polotov is down. And seriously, one rocket will take that out. Even one snipe will take it out. Red is losing a lot of players right now, and the sentry gun finally does go down. I think at this point you have to fall back and protect Roof. We'll see if they do so, though. Oh no! Medic didn't know there was a mini sentry down there, and Boa did take a lot of damage, but will survive. Oh no! There's a Kaber! Kaber in the field, but Coliseum protects his medic. Oh man, that is when you buy your scout a drink after the game. Thank you for saving my life, sir and or madam. I'm just gonna go ahead and say, sir. We'll check in on the Dr. Dratini because there is some absolute chaos going over. It does get the backstab and a hose call me Darby, who's trying to take down that teleporter. I think the teleporter is still up. No, actually, did go down? Whatever. And we'll see now if Duff can do something, but not going to be able to. Wait, was he dead? He was dead ringing. Of course he was, because that's how spies do it. We'll keep on the Dr. Dratini cam, because again, spy's been doing crazy work. Oh, sniper, you're so dead. Oh, poor mini sentry, you're so dead. So Dr. Dratini going, a Dr. Dratini. He's not the Dr. Dratini, he's just one of them. So getting some nice defense on there. We'll see how long Rags can hold for this. They have already backed up, which is the good call. They need to be building on Roof. Oh, this is how you can tell what has happened. It looks like there is a popsicle engineer and the sentry gun is down. So I'm guessing somebody paid him a visit, and that somebody was not his dear Aunt Sally. And if you grew up in the 90s in America, you know that reference. I assume that, anyway. We'll watch this blue as he tries to defend the house right now, but right now it's looking pretty desperate as blue team is pushing, but again, Rags has Roof. So this is what we saw in second half of the second round. Rags holding roof while THC just kind of ignores it and continues to push. They did stop pushing right there as they're probably trying to get together some sort of coordinated uber push with maybe a spy sap or some sort of fun stuff like that. We'll see if they can do so. Let's check on the sniper cam. Oh, Riku does get trace up right there as snipers. How do they work? How do they work? How are they doing, too, is the question. Both having a little bit of trouble right here. Well, of course, they're not really gonna score huge amounts of points on Badwater, but often their purpose is just to close down this lane, because having knowledge that that sniper is there with a dot trained on your head is sometimes enough. We do have the blue uber popped, but not able to get onto the roof, and here we go! Blue is still pushing right here. Uber popped on the engineer. Oh man, doesn't matter though when you have your demo and your scout as support. So does stay up. Somehow Cornholio got behind the lines and was spamming rockets, but Polotov will keep his baby up. As we have about 4 minutes and 9 seconds left. Remember, this is the first half of this this here round, so if Rags could pull off a second point defense, that'd be huge, be absolutely huge for them, and make that second half a lot easier. We will see though, I mean, 4 minutes of course is a long time to defend a roof, and they don't even have a dispenser. There we go, dispenser finally going up. Of course I was just messing with you, Polotov. I know how hard it is to get stuff up on the roof when you're constantly under fire. Especially if there's a demo man behind you. That is the worst. Let's get on his cam. Oh, actually, we're probably going to see a push here. A soft push. No Uber to speak of. And indeed, they are pushing forward. And Sentry Gun just melts in front of them. Only a couple up for Red on the roof. And will they be able to do so? Not without a medic. And indeed, they will fall back. Oh, Steve. And this blue jumped down only to jump into the mini Sentry that was their demise. Cyanide really wants this. Probably not completely necessary, considering he only had already had 100%. Oh! 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 Turn around! Okay, they know he's here. That's the first step. Knowing is the first step. But it's not the last step, and indeed he's still alive. Dr. Dratini making the best use out of that dead ringer, and he could do some big here if he forces the drop or some sort of other stellar play. Cyanide is pushing forward right now, and he actually will pop that Uber. Stays safely alive. That Sentry Gun again is in the house, only level 1, but it looks like Polotov will pick it up and protect his little baby. Cyanide's Uber does fall away. He's not going to survive though. That Sentry Gun finally picked him off. Rag's medic went down as well. But the Sentry Gun, or the cart, is going to be stopped for a little bit longer. Let's check out Polotov. And yeah, he managed to get that level 3 up. He's got that dispenser. We'll see how long he can keep it up for. This position, seen it a different engineering theory, I guess, for defending third right here. For this, you have to wrangle. You can get those long shots, but you're not necessarily going to protect the card. And there's always the chance that a spy is going to come up from behind you and force your death. So there we go. But Sentry Gun's still up. We'll see if he can do a little more work right here. As everyone for blue tries to get it, actually taking down Danny right there. It's on fire. It's, oh, the story of the century. This is your life. It sucks. What is staying up right there? I wonder if Polotov got a a teleporter down. Actually, he doesn't, but he is running desperately to save his poor baby, and he's gonna make it. Oh man, the life of an engineer. Beautiful. Does get it. He actually took the ammo right there because he fired one shot. But no! Oh no! He's now on the spy hunt. He's got that southern hospitality, but oh, his sentry goes down. Oh, so sad. So very sad. He's going to give up on this point, and that is the rest of that. We're probably done with the Polotov camera for right now, as he's going to fall back to third and build up right there. We do have an Uber. Oh, Steve goes down. A host called me Darby. Not able to get that pop off in time. And we do have Red with an Uber now. However, they're not going to be able to do anything with that. And very unfortunate. Cyanide is staying alive, does have this 100% Uber, and we're going to see this push in, which could be the demise of Rags, as they are 5 down right now. Do get some respawns, but if they can't get anything up, oh hey, there's a sentry or a sniper dot, so yeah, good call to kind of watch out for that. Riku is alive, and No is gonna have to fall back into spawn. This is a big push from Blue, they need to just get it done. Oh, Devil Man drops down, and actually they do not lose. Scary. Everybody else from Blue drops down as well. We'll see if they can get him. Steve is just spun up and firing like crazy. He does have that medic on him, and Eli is alive as well. Survived that with a little bit of health. Axel again survived. Colosseum tracks down Sputnik, tracks down Cyanide. Colosseum. I can't remember if I said that correctly. Finally goes down. You can hear the screams. Oh man, the scout is so dramatic. Like, seriously, it can't hurt that bad to be covered in urine and then have a bushwhacker go through your skull. I mean, like, come on. Oh, poor, poor TF2 characters. Let's check out Raikou Camp. Oh, as soon as he zoomed out, I think we saw a medic jump across. And of course, he's just watching a very narrow area right now. But again, that sniper dot can do so much to discourage pushing it through that area. Watch this Sputnik Cam, as we've seen a lot of action here on the flanks. Oh no, he's got the Boston Basher out, which of course is a helpful for building, but not helpful in melee fights against a spy. We'll see if Duff can do something here. He is running that Spicicle, as we saw some popsicles earlier, but Dr. Dratini gets that stab first. I do have 100% Uber ready for red. If I were a gambling woman, I would say that they're not going to do anything offensive with this, because that is the way that both teams have been playing, and it's a good way to go. I would like to see some crits, just because I like crits. And Devil Man with crits, Badwater last can be so ridiculous. Like, let's go explore fantasy world where they do have crits right now, and it is perfectly charged and everything. Okay, so they would have to deal with the mini sentry right up here, but look at how everybody is gathered around the water cooler. 3 crit stickies could take out more than half of the blue team right now. Of course, that is in fantasy world where they have charged crits, but instead we do have charged Ubers. Blue is coming in with this push right now. Uber is popped. Red is trying to lay as long as possible, but not able to do so for too long. Sentry gun does go down, and Blue's Uber does finally wear off. Red had it for just a little bit longer. Spy in on Medic. Is Boa going to survive? He actually does survive. However, Duff is still around and threatening. Boa is super hurt right now, but Steve doing a good job taking out the mini incarnations of Duff, and Gary staying alive as well. So another defensive hold right there from Rags. So far, it is continuing with the tradition and the trend of this this match, which is to hold Badwater last so your opponent cannot cap it. We'll see though, they've got 4 minutes and 45 seconds left, and Blue is just really threatening now. They are getting very, very aggressive, playing a little more, reckless. We did see in the kill feed that Cyanide took a headshot and went down, so, and Raikou actually got another shot after that. Oh man, Duff ran right into some flames right there, so I want to get on the Riku. Actually, Riku is down, so after he got those headshots, he was rewarded with a lovely death. This Blue is, yeah, not going to survive. That took one final hit as he jumped out the window. Let's get on the Riku cam right now, see what he can't accomplish with his zoomy, snipey gun. That's what, I assume that's what my 4-year-old niece would call it. And he does get a headshot right there on Sputnik. He's gotten a couple headshots on Sputnik as a scout, so pretty impressive right there. I always feel pretty ashamed when I get sniped as a scout, but then again, I am a terrible scout. Alright, we do have 100% ready for red. It looks like we're just gonna have to wait on Cyanide, though. We'll see if Raikou can't do anything to delay this push. How is Sputnik alive again? Alright, because he's a scout and he runs incredibly fast. And I'm hoping I'm saying Raikou's name correctly. Riku? Raikou? feel like it's an anime thing, but not sure. We have a desperate sniper battle going on right here. Who's going to win? Oh, it looks like Riku did get a shot off right there. Did he? Yeah, Tricep finally going down right there. But this blue helping him out. Oh my goodness, we'll see if Riku can't finish off Cyanide, who's incredibly hurt right now. The Uber did not go as planned for blue, and it looks like, again, another hold. Keys, there we go. Another hold for the red team. In this case, random assortment of gentlemen. I feel like that's like... Their team logo should be like Whitman's sampler, you know, those box of chocolates where you have just random chocolates, but it should be Whitman's random assortment of gentlemen. That would be adorable. I would like it. Of course, every time I go away from Riku or whatever, he gets a nice headshot, Sputnik going down right there. No, that was a spy, Steve. You're right. Go with your instincts. Does take down Duff, but again, that DR, never safe. Let's actually go to the Duff cam right now, as he's still alive, and we'll go to Dr. Chitini, because all the spies are the same, right? Actually, Duff just goes down right there, so good thing we weren't on his cam. Dr. Chitini, also running the Dead Ringer. I just haven't been on his cam as much, because I'm sure he's been using it. It's so nice. Trying to get in behind the cart, but there's nobody on the cart. And continue to push forward. We have this huge push by Blue. However, that Sentry Gun is wrangled and so lethal. Not sure what Conholio is doing right there. But most of Blue Team is down and has gone down to that Sentry Gun. Meanwhile, Raikou got another headshot on Sputnik. This poor scout. Or this amazing sniper. Whichever you want to say. It could... Also, both could be true. Also, neither could be true. Could just be a glitch in the matrix that Sputnik is going down so much. Meanwhile, this blue is continuing with his ranging work. I don't know, he's just doing a good job shutting down map room right now, as there's only a few seconds left, or actually about a minute left right here. He's just gonna stay in here and shut down this access to the cart. And if Rags can pull this off, well, history would say that they will win the second half of this round, but again, nothing is for certain in TF2 except dropped critses and heavy tutus. The Sentry Gun is all the way up, but Cyanide is going to have an Uber very soon. However, Red will have one in retaliation. Get ready to pop it on the Pyro, because that's the only way that you'll be able to save this gun. And right, it is popped on the Pyro, but Blue Team pops it on the Pyro. Interesting decision right there, and yeah, Cotnip is just gonna get in there and M1 the heck out of that Sentry Gun. It will be successful. The Blue Uber is popped. For some reason, the Heavy is running away with his fists. Oh, his gloves are running urgently. Not sure why he didn't have the gun out right there, but it may not matter, as Qualiseum is in on the cart doing crazy work as usual. Raikou gets a good headshot on Cornholio, and this will be a defensive hold again on the last point of Badwater. Oh my goodness. It just seems like these teams are very uncreative and could only think of one way to play this game. And they're just doing it times three. But it's been really entertaining. Let's see, it looks like we do have a pause. Alright, we are back after the pause for a little TF2 on... Actually, they're not ice skating. Well, I am disappointed. looks like we have somebody from THC drop. And I think we also have somebody new for Rags. I thought I saw somebody new join up. Maybe not. Alright, so yeah, THC still down a player. That is gonna be huge. It looks like Eli, there we go. Eli wasn't spec, but he will be joining. So they will have a full team win trying to hold on to all 4 points for the victory in this here match, which has been crazy hard fought. Now, I mentioned this earlier, but I didn't actually comment on it because I got distracted, which is pretty typical of me, that Danny O is running the regular wrench. And I'm confused about that. There's, I feel like the Jag at least is a slight upgrade. Or the Eureka effect, we've actually seen that used a lot on Badwater first, popularized by Dave Plus of the Syndicate last year. Dave's actually taking a break this season, which makes me very sad, but I understand. It looks like we did lose Cyanide, Medic for THC, so we may have a pause here soon. Regardless, no pause, no problem, and that could be huge for THC in their defense, as it looks like Blue's gonna... Oh, but no, we have the drop! Eli with the fill takes down Boa, who took a lot of damage, was thinking about popping, I assume, and then did not have another second to think about it, but only to die. So unfortunate right there. But still no pause or anything going on, so we're gonna play 8 down for THC. We'll watch Dr. Dratini as he attracts some attention from that wrangled sentry gun. But we're pulling out that Dead Ringer, so yes, he has been using it to the best of its ability. Ooh, was that a bump? We do have Cyanide back in the game, but so far not back on the team. Again, the HUD is... Oh! Ouchie. Ouchie, Wawa. Saw on the kill feed right there that Riku got... Duff got a couple of nice backstabs right there. Will not be enough, though, to stop this first point from going down. It looks like defense is pretty shabby right now. We still have some pyro and power action, but no, Cotnip is not going to be able to do this by himself, and he does go down. As first point is capped. Ding! There we go. Remember, they have... Oh, the HUD. We'll see if it's refreshed by now. Nope, looks like we still have to wait a little bit longer, because that's the way... the way the ball rolls or whatever in TF2. As Axel has spotted out a medic all by himself, working on him, but taking a lot of needles in the process, finally pulls out that reserve shooter. Oh, and dies to the needles. Looks like Sputnik is on medic. Okay, so Sputnik went med while Cyanide was still rejoining. Looks like Cyanide is on scout, so interesting. We'll see how that goes. We'll see if they keep up with that. Probably just waiting for someone to die and then they'll change. Yeah, it looks like Sputnik is just gonna kill himself. He had a 50% Uber charge right there, so we will see. This may be a time to go to crits, because look how far Blue is pushed up right now with this Uber. Oh man, what is this? What is Danio doing? He was trying to protect his dispenser, I guess, but needed to probably fall back and build up something that lasts right now. Most of Blue team is up, and actually that's all they need, because if they capped it in less than that 6 minutes and 20 seconds for third, they will win the game. And unfortunate loss right there for THC, but well played nonetheless. Indeed, it was a GG. And I guess I'll put a little black time after this, because I don't want to spoil all the fun. But yeah, those losing players is never good, especially when it's one of them is the medic. Oh man, Payload, that is the life of Payload, but well played nonetheless. So congrats to Random Assortment of Gentlemen, or as I will now call them, Whitman's Random Assortment of Gentlemen. And I hope one of them knows how to Photoshop and make that image. Hope you guys know what I'm talking about too. Anyway guys, thanks so much for watching. Thank you to Riku. I probably didn't say your name correctly, which upsets me, because you were really nice in sending this email with all the information about this match, so thank you so much for that. Also, thanks for watching since the beginning too. That makes me really happy. Alright, so thanks for watching, everybody else. Even if you haven't been watching for a year now, I still forgive you. But that's about it for me. Thanks so much. I don't know how many more times I can say thank you, so I'm just gonna say goodbye. Bye!